In the previous part, we have seen the first step, that is how the sperms approach up to the egg. Now the next step, once the sperms reach closer to the egg in the fallopian tube, then they have to identify each other. That means the gametes need to identify each other, and this is known as fertilizing, anti-fertilizing reaction. It is not a reaction, it is simply an identification. Fertilizing is secreted by the ovum or by the egg. Fertilizing is a chemical which has spermophilic sites. Spermophilic sites are the places where the sperms are going to get attached. Anti-fertilizing is a substance which is secreted by the sperms. Now, why this identification? So that the uniqueness of the species can be maintained. What is going to happen is, suppose this is the membrane of the egg. On the membrane of the ovum would be produced this fertilizing, and say fertilizing has these sites which are called spermophilic sites. At this spermophilic sites, the sperms are going to bind. Now, because of this, only limited number of sperms will be able to bind. We said 100 sperms reach up to the fallopian tube. Suppose there are only fertilizing molecules are produced. Every fertilizing would bind to 2 or 3 sperms. That means from those 100, now the number has gone even lower. Maybe 10, 15, 12 sperms will be able to come closer to the egg or will be able to bind. So the significance of fertilizer anti-fertilizing reaction is to maintain specificity or uniqueness of a species. And second importance is to thin out the number of sperms. Thin out the number of sperms. So now out of 100, even lesser sperms are actually getting attached to the outer surface of the ovum. The next thing which is going to take place is the acrosome is going to rupture, releasing the sperm lysis. So that is going to be the step 3. So let us talk about what happens after this one. Next step is going to be release of sperm lysis. Sperm lysins are basically lytic enzymes, and there are 3 enzymes which are present in this secretion. First, corona penetrating enzyme, and sometimes it is also written as corona digesting enzyme. The second one is hyaluronidase, and third is going to dissolve the zona pellucida. It is called acrosin. So these 3 are released. Together they are known as sperm lysins. Let us write down their function and then we'll see what they do. First one, that is corona penetrating enzyme or corona digesting enzyme, digests the cells of the corona radiata membrane. Corona radiata layer, the cells are digested by this enzyme. These cells of corona radiata, they are held together by a gelatinous glue-like material. Suppose this is the membrane of the egg, and here are these cells. So these cells which make this corona radiata, they are glued together with the help of the substance. This substance is hyaluronic acid. So this hyaluronidase actually dissolves this hyaluronic acid so that the cells, they loosen up and there is a passage for the entry of spore. So hyaluronidase enzyme would digest hyaluronic acid, which is actually acting as a glue. And acrosin is going to digest the zona pellucida. That means all the three layers which are there. There is a corona radiata layer, the cells which are there, they are held together by the substance that is also digested, and zona pellucida. So outside vitelline membrane, the two layers which are there, they are digested. Spores always enter through the animal pole. So here the lysins have been released, and this is possible because the acrosome membrane was made weaker. It was made weaker in the female reproductive tract by the process of capacitation. The next step is formation of a reception cone. Formation of reception cone. And this sometimes is also known as fertilization cone or fertilization cone. Whenever the sperm comes in or comes closer to the egg, it has dissolved all the membranes. Say we just make few layers here, and the nucleus is inside. That means this is the animal pole. So when the sperm approaches or comes closer to the vitelline membrane, the acrosome has already ruptured. This is the head part and here is the tail. The egg membrane produces a conical structure. This conical structure is known as the fertilization cone. This is the point from where the membranes are going to dissolve and fuse, so that now the nucleus can be introduced into the ovum. But before that, few more changes are going to take place. Which is that next change which we'll be taking up? This egg, which we normally are using the word egg or ovum, is not really an egg yet. It is a secondary oocyte. This secondary oocyte has to change into the egg. It has to still undergo one division. That division is completion of meiosis II, which would result in formation of the egg in the second polar body. This division is triggered when the sperm touches the membrane. So after this, what's going to happen is, as soon as the egg membrane and the sperm membrane, they fuse, or in other words, we say that the sperm touches the membrane of the egg, second meiotic division would take place. Oogenesis is still not complete. So in the next part, we will talk about what happens next after the sperm.